Hi, this is Rich, and we're going to talk about the top three fears that people have about getting out of body or astral projecting. Now, this is from like 40 years of experience working with the subject, to helping people get out of body and talking to people about their issues and things like this. And so this is where I've gotten these first top three fears for getting out of body, okay? Now, what we're going to do in this video is, well, let me put it this way. Have you ever wondered what lies beyond the physical world, but we're kind of afraid to take a peek? Or you've thought about getting out of body, but again, I don't know. Are these three, or is one of these three fears one of your fears or worries or concerns? And hopefully you're not worried or concerned at all, because we're actually going to debunk these three fears. They're like, no, don't be afraid. Okay, so we're going to dive into this and I'm going to share with you how you can get past these fears. All right. All right. So in the next, never mind. Let's just get started. So the first one is the fear of meeting scary entities. Yeah. Yeah. A lot of people are afraid that if they get out of body, they're going to encounter these freaky entities. And one, yes, it's possible. It could happen. Not likely, but it can happen. Okay. So if it does happen, what you need to know about these scary entities is they're lower astral beings of relatively low psychic oomph. They're not like super demons or astral parasites. That's a whole different entity phenomena. It doesn't have to do with getting out of body. When you get out of body, you're doing a consciousness shift, and you're waking up while the physical body is asleep, and you're waking up in some kind of a belief system territory, which may be a lower astral place, a middle astral place, higher causal plane, mental plane, if you're using those kinds of labels and experiencing those kinds of phenomena. But when you get out of body, your deeper belief systems kick in, your beliefs, your feelings, your intentions, the kind of love or hate, fear or compassion you have in your heart is going to dictate where you're going to arrive. So the chances of you meeting a scary freaking entity are very slim. But if you do encounter one, just confront it. Look at it. It's like a child in a Halloween costume. Ooh, and they are scaring a neighbor, adult, that doesn't get it. And the little kid is absolutely delighted that they can scare an adult and bamboozle an adult into thinking they are a real scary entity. They're just a child being mischievous, okay? So that's a lot of what you're going to find if you even do encounter a scary entity. Just face it, look at it, and you'll be fine. I know who you are and I know what you're doing is a good turn of phrase. And just confront it. Because what they'll do, they'll try to scare you back into your physical body. They want to shake up your emotional state and your concentration and your intention to run to safety. And that's what they'll do. Okay? So I've encountered them myself. The first time it happened, I was like, it was like scary as could be. This entity, it was like this kind of greenish yellow leathery skin. It's kind of like that. And it's got these sharp teeth and these big yellow eyes with these, you know, black slits. And it's like looking right at me. but I could sense and feel its intention. And its intention was to scare me. And it, and it was like that close, too. I woke up. It was a consciousness shift. I went out of phase with my physical body. I was wide awake, and my physical body was asleep. I was laying down on my stomach. My head was like this. And this thing was like, nah! And I'm like, what the fuck? But I just maintained my confront and my position and just looked at it. And finally it gave up. Fuck you. And it drifted away. They are harmless. They can only mess with your mind, your thoughts, thinking, feelings, and emotions. Okay. So, not to worry. Confront them, you're good. Let's talk about the next thing. There's this idea of soul traps, right? Now, the thing about a soul trap, what that is a mechanism of some kind that will trap a being that is not in a physical body. They're in their soul essence, presence, okay? So, we hear a lot about this when we're talking about afterlife experiences, okay? So when somebody dies, depending on how they think, what they believe, their emotional frequency, what they're afraid of or what they embrace, this all plays a part in their afterlife experience. And most people, probably 90% of the people that drop dead, they're going to go to a realm that is suitable for their emotional and spiritual nature. If a person is a very loving and religious person, let's say they're a Christian, they could be any other religion too, but they have love and compassion and forgiveness and all this stuff, they will find themselves in a realm, an afterlife realm. It's not an astral plane. If you want to label it an astral plane, perfect. Do so. But these are just labels. The phenomena is that a person like that will find themselves in a territory, belief system, territory, realm of their own imagining, but it will be in tune, usually, in tune with other beings of like mind, heart, and spirit. And so they will be with their own people, your own tribe. Again, no worries about soul traps. Unless you got some freaking fetish and some weird compulsive fear about getting caught in a soul trap in your afterlife. It's not going to happen when you get out of body or when you drop dead. Okay. It will happen when you drop dead if you're thinking like that, because you are creating your reality and your afterlife reality by virtue of what you're thinking and feeling predominantly and on a deep level. So if you've got shit going on and you're like really freaking out about a soul trap thing because you watched a video here, watched a video there, read something the other place about soul traps, yeah, they do exist, but not for most people. Okay, it can happen, but it will happen to those people who are consciously or unconsciously creating those things. It has to do with that phenomena of what you fear you get, what you resist will persist. It's because you have to think it and feel it, thus create it in your imagination, and thus it manifests in either your physical life or your afterlife. So people who are concerned about soul traps, which is some kind of phenomena you find yourself in and as a soul being, you can't get out of, right? So they can exist, but they're not the usual fare for humans who drop dead. for most people that drop dead or, you know, pass on into higher planes, they will go to their loving tribe or people or belief system territory. So people will go into their religious realm, if that's what they're into. If they're atheistic, they're going to be with, they're going to be hanging out. Now, the reason I know this is through personal experience, through exploration while out of body. For 40 years, 50, I've been interested in the subject, and for about 35 years, I've been able to get out of body, and I would always go exploring and learning things. My higher self would guide me into experiences for an educational reason, and I would learn these things. I go, wow, that's interesting. So one time, I was out of body, and I'm going, what, where am I? And it's all foggy. There's a little lamppost over here, and there's gravel parking lot, and there's old clunkers under the lamppost. I'm going, where am I? There's old asphalt road going like this, and going into the distant fog that way, and like, what's over? And over here is Dewdrop Inn. It's like a little roadside tavern. I'm going, what the hell? I'm wide awake. I'm not in my physical experience, and I know it. I go, my God, I'm here. What's this? And I go crunch, crunch, crunch as I walk across the gravel. And I go into the little tavern. And it's that real, it's that quiet, kind of eerie. It's dark in there. And there's little tables here and there. And there's about like 15 or 20 people in there. Two guys sitting here. A woman sitting over there by herself at the table. A few guys at the bar. People at other tables, and I go, what is this place? And I look around, I can smell the tobacco in the air and the liquor. Wow, this is weird. It's similar to places you'll find here in the physical world, right? And it was not threatening, it was just like kind of empty and lonely with a lot of, I would say, lost souls. And I looked at him, I go, wow, okay. I get it. I know what this is. So I turned around and I walked out. And that was my learning experience. Except, as I was walking out, and I was going, what am I going to do now? One of the guys from the bar come out following me, chasing after me. He says, hey. I go, yeah? What? He says, like, I'm lost. How do I get out of here? What do I do from here? And a light came on. I said, oh, this is an afterlife realm for people who they don't have an afterlife belief system, really. Except their default state. These are people that they were lonely, and in their physical life, this is where they came to relax or chill. They'd go to their local, you know, their drinking pub or their local bar or whatever, and have a few drinks, talk to their friends. But that was it. They had no clue about an afterlife. And they weren't religious. So this became their afterlife experience. It was by default, what do you get when you die? I don't know. What they get is what they think about and feel about predominantly. And they found themselves in an environment with people like themselves. So, no soul trap there. It's just where you go, okay? So if you've got worries and concerns about soul traps, you know, you want to deal with them now. And you can deal with them like doing emotional release work, belief system release work, things like that, soul contract revocations, things like that. I'm just saying, okay? All right. What else we got? Oh, the other fear is fear of not being able to return to the physical body. Have you ever had that one? I've met people with that one. I met a guy one time that he didn't want to go out of body because, he didn't want to go out of body because he was afraid he would leave and not want to come back. So that's fear number four, but we weren't going to talk about that. But we're going to talk about it because I brought it up. But this guy, I was doing an out-of-body boot camp training course, live interactive. And so I'm talking to him on Zoom, and you know, with the group. And come to find out, he could get the vibrations. He could get the sleep paralysis. He could get the phase shift real easy just by meditating. But he'd start to get those setups for getting out, for, you know, once you get into sleep paralysis state, you've phase shifted. And now you're ready to rock and roll. All you got to do is a few techniques for separating from your physical body in that same space and place that you're in. You're superimposed or juxtaposed over your physical body, right? So, okay, and you're out. But you got to know a few techniques. So anyway, he could get to the phase shift place, but his fear would kick in. And we dug into it. We found out his fear was that if he did get out, he would never come back. So that prevented him from getting out. Well, one, it doesn't work that way because it's once you get out, you're still connected to your physical body because your physical body is still alive and you have deep-seated beliefs and soul contract agreements to stick with the body, not abandon it, not walk away. And these are pretty locked in and very deep. So you can't get away, get out, and not come back, almost no matter how hard you try. These things are locked in. You had some agreements. You're not going anywhere, dude. Okay? You're just like... So this deep-seated agreement phenomena and belief phenomena and mechanism will cause you to snap back to the physical body with various thoughts and feelings, stuff like that. So there is absolutely no fear of not being able to return. It's the other way around. Fear of not being able to stay out long enough would be a bigger fucking problem. Okay, just saying. But some people do here have the fear of can't get back. And it's just not a thing because it's almost impossible to not get back, even if you work real hard to stay out longer. Okay? So get over that one because that's just not a fear. Okay? It's not going to, it doesn't happen. It doesn't work that way. Okay? This is 40 years of experience talking here. Talk to hundreds of people. Okay. All right. Just saying. All right. So, that's what I wanted to share with you. These three fears debunked. Okay. Don't worry about the entities. It's a big bluff job. No worries. If you do, yeah, that's even if you do encounter them. And soul traps, no. It's more of an issue if you fucking die, but you're not dying, you're just going out of body. But even if you were to die or go out of body, the soul trap phenomenon, although it exists, is very unusual, not normal for most people. And you will know if you have some like super fear, worry, or concern about that thing, you want to address that while you're still alive and awake in your physical body, release those fears, get over it. If it's worth it to you, if getting out of body and exploring the vastness of the multiverse is important to you, and this is it can be like this. This is beautiful. It's amazing. There's so many wonderful things you can experience when you do get out of body. Astral travel, consciousness shift, reality shifting, whatever you want to call it. Okay. All right. Anything else I want to mention here? I do have a course on how to get out of body. It's called OOBE Boot Camp. If you're interested in that sort of thing, it will teach you how to safely and confidently get out of body. Okay? All right. That's all I wanted to share with you today. Thank you for watching, and I will talk to you later. If you have any questions about getting out of body, drop them in a comment below, and I'm happy to answer them for you. Okay? All righty. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.